Graph each equation on your own paper, then drag the equation to match the correct graph. This lesson is focusing on the standard form or intercept form graphing method, so we're going to go ahead and use that method here. Let's look at this equation. 3x plus 5y equals 15. Well, what we need to do is we need to go ahead and find the x-intercept and the y-intercept. And the way you find the x-intercept, for example, is you ignore this y part, this 5y, and you just use 3x equals 15. And then to solve it, you divide by 3, and you get x equals 5. That means that the intercept on the x-axis for this equation is going to be 5. So put a dot there on x equals 5. Same idea for the y. You want to find the y-intercept. What you do is you ignore the x term. So you just have 5y equals 15. And then divide by 5. And you get y equals 3. Okay, y equals 3. And then you make a point on the y-axis at 3. Okay. Now these are the two points that your line's going to go through. Then you go ahead and connect the dots with a straight line. Something like that. You could probably draw your line a little straighter than I did. Okay, so that means this 3x plus 5y equals 15. That's going to go with this guy down here. We'll number this 4. And we'll do this 3, 2, 1. So this one's going to be number 4. Okay, for the next one, negative 5x plus 3y equals 15. Do the work down here. Negative 5x for the x-intercept, we're going to do negative 5x equals 15. And then divide by negative 5, we're going to get x equals negative 3. So I'm going to put a point on the x-axis at x equals negative 3 right there. Then for the y, I'm going to do 3y equals 15. So divide by 3, both sides, y equals 5. So I'm going to put a point at y equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right there. Now these are the two points that the line has to go through. These are the two intercepts. So then draw a line right through there, like that. Okay, now this one looks like it matches with number 3. Okay, now let's look at the next one. 5x minus 3y equals 15. Here's the work for that one. I'm going to do 5x equals 15 first, and then divide by 5. So x equals 3. Then I'm going to put a point at x equals 3. And then for the y value, it's going to use negative 3y equals 15. Then divide by negative 3, both sides. So y equals negative 5. I'm going to put a point on y equals negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right there. And then go ahead and draw a straight line through those two points. And technically in math, all lines are straight, but I like to emphasize a straight line. Draw as best you can. And you can even use a straight edge if you want to. I don't have the advantage of doing that with my little electronic pen, but you can use a straight edge, and that's totally fine. Looks like this guy matches up with graph number 2 right here. So I'm going to put a 2 here, which means this last one has to be number 1, but I'm going to go ahead and do the work for it anyway. So here's the last one. So negative 3x minus 5y equals 15. I'm going to do negative 3x equals 15, divide by negative 3. we get x equals negative 5. And then for the y, it's going to be negative 5y equals 15. And then divide by negative 5, both sides, y equals negative 3. Now in this one, I calculated the values for the intercepts first, and then I'm going to plot them both now. It's okay to do it that way. So for the x-intercept, it's negative 5, 5 to the left of the origin. And for the y-intercept, it's 3 down from the origin. So the line's going to go through those two points. Like that. And that one looks like graph number 1. Which is good, because that was the only one left. So this standard form graphing method, or intercept form graphing method, is actually very easy if the equation is written in this type of form. So I suggest you use it whenever possible.